You probably know that you can use React with frameworks like Next.js or Remix to build full-stack React websites and web applications. But did you know that you can actually also use React basically as a template engine with Express.js, for example, to build full-stack websites without using Next.js or Remix? And in this video, I'll show you how to do that, why you might want to do it, and what the differences compared to Next.js or Remix websites are. Now let's start with the how. How can you use React as a template engine in a Node Express app? And the idea is that you use it in exactly the same way as you would use EJS or Handlebars. You register it as a view engine, you then set it as a default view engine, and you then call render to then render a view with that engine, which means that you need to have a file with the specified file name and the specified extension in the specified views folder. Now I'll show you how to set up React as an engine and how to register it in just a second, but in this case, if React is registered as a view engine, that then means that your view file simply contains a React component as you know it from your standard React apps. And in that component, you can use other components and you can pass props to those components, and then also extract and output these props, just as you would do it in a normal React app. Now, unlike in normal React apps, you won't use React features like the useState or useEffect hooks, though, because all those views, all those React components that are being registered and combined here are in the end only rendered once on the server, since we're only using them as views with our React view engine. And the question therefore is, what happens in that engine registration step here? Well, in the end, in this step, a custom view engine is registered, and that happens according to the Express.js documentation. And it in the end simply means that a function is set up, which receives the path to the view file, then an options object, and then a callback. And inside of this function, I'm then importing that file from that file path. I'm then getting hold of the default export in there, which in the end simply means I'm getting hold of the exported component, which is set up as the default export in my project here. And I then call render to static markup, which is a function imported from the React DOM package. And there it's imported from the server side capabilities and functionalities of that package. And this function does what its name implies. It takes a React component and all the nested components you might have in there, and it renders that component tree to static HTML markup. So it converts all these components to standard HTML elements in the end. And that's what's then returned, stored, and in the end, sent back to Express with help of that callback. Now I'm also doing some additional things here. For one, I'm adding this doc type tag here, since this can't easily be added here directly in the JSX code. That's not something that would work. Therefore here in my solution, I'm adding this as the view gets parsed and handled by my custom engine. And I'm using one special React feature here, which is the React context feature. I did mention that using useState or useEffect doesn't make a lot of sense because the React code gets executed only once on the server side. You don't get an interactive or reactive client-side application. You don't get any client-side React code. But I'm using this context feature here to provide this options object to all the components that might be interested. And that's important because this options object, which is received by my custom view engine function here, in the end, for example, will include any data that's passed to the render function. And that simply allows me to access that data in any nested component without having to pass that data down through props so that I can output it in any component that needs to output it. But that's in the end all. I'm not using any other React features, and as you can tell, it also doesn't take a lot of complex code to use React and JSX code as a template engine. However, if you were to just add this function to your Node Express application, and you would then register this function as a template engine, you would run into errors because out of the box, Node doesn't know how to handle JSX code. That's why, besides installing Express and React and React DOM, you also need to install some Babel packages, which will handle the JSX to JavaScript conversion. You also need to set up such a Babel config.js file, and you need to set up such a register.js file, though the file name is up to you, which in the end simply tells Node.js that this Babel package should be used for parsing files in this application. Node.js is then made aware of this register.js file when the Node application is started with help of this special flag. But that's then truly all it takes to use React with JSX as a template engine. And therefore, the obvious question might be, why would you do that? Why would you use that instead of just using Next.js or Remix? And the answer is, it simply depends on what you're trying to build. If you want to build a full-stack application with React, where you can also use React on the client side then to build highly reactive and interactive web user interfaces, you should go for Next.js or Remix or similar frameworks. Because those frameworks will not just use React and JSX to pre-render HTML pages, but they will then also hydrate those pages and make them interactive and also load React on the client side. And that's not happening here with this demo application when just using React and JSX as a template engine. There, React is really only used to produce those HTML documents. But thereafter, once they have been produced, there is no React-controlled reactivity on the client side, and the React library is not loaded on the client side. But of course, you also don't need React in all the websites you're building. You just might want to use it because you like working with JSX and because you like building your views with help of components. And that's when this React template engine then could be very useful. You could, for example, combine it with HTMX, about which I recently released a course in case you're interested, to still add client-side interactivity, but without writing all that React-specific code you would have to write if you would use React on that client side. As always, it's a trade-off and simply depends on your requirements.